Everybody, good evening. We are in Antwerp, Belgium. It's the Basketball Champions League Final Four. It is the first semifinal, and it's Sega Fredo versus Bologna in the white winning the opening tip, going up against Borussia Bamberg from Freak City, Germany. Kevin Punter, who won it last year with Ike, misses with his first attempt. Runner in the lane. Maybe stats-wise, don't know if Justin Cesis, but he certainly has a lot of say in how this game is going to go. Now to Alexander, had a terrific quarterfinal against Ike. And an early foul call. It's going to be Correa.
Look at the spacing, Jeff. Every Bamberg guy giving him space to play, stretching the defense. Good to see him go inside early. I really think that activity, athleticism on the inside is going to be an issue.
Tyrese Rice misses with his first attempt. Now Kevin Punter to bump from Alindi. So Alindi that gets the assignment on Punter. Interesting. Now Martin going up against Cesis. He might like that matchup. He's going to pull his way down low. Oh, he gets rejected by Alexander. Five on the shot clock. They're going to have to hurry up. Tony Taylor is going to launch it. And he's going to miss everything but the backboard.
The issue for Bologna there, they went inside, but no one moved. Everyone was able to stand, and the rotations were all set. And he just comes across, does what he does. No one on the perimeter moved. No one actually created any action away from the basketball. It's definitely their tempo, Jeff.
Rice, maybe the favorite to get the MVP of the year award. Up and in. Well, that's a good sign. He wants to see that ball going through the hoop.
Absolutely. Leading scorer in this Champions League, Basketball Champions League history for him. His performances lately have just been so unlike him. If he comes to play, he gets a lot of shots when he's on the floor. He's going to have to get double digits. He's probably going to have to get 15 for him to get the chance. Great little mid-range jumper to get him going.
Taylor, that's his first. Now Cesis pulls up, little mid-ranger.
What were we saying? The guy who comes and does what he needs to do at the right time.
Well, he hit the game-winning shot in the German Cup earlier this year. Get Marcus Bamberg that trophy.
So much better. Went inside, a lot of movement. Everyone could see the ball. Great pass.
Lindy, his entry pass. And a little bit of a tug. And Correa is going to have to go out of the game with his second foul. That means Dan Kravic is going to check in. Here it is again. And Alexander trying to post up.
Kravic is going to have to play as hard and as quick as he can. He will struggle athletically, but he's big and strong. Got to make him take some space up on the inside, and he's really got to work hard. That's too early for Moray to go out.
That's way too early. Cesis beat. Wow! And gets it to Alexander for an alley one-handed jam. Boy, has he come to life in the playoffs. He has been unreal already with a swat tonight. Now with the play of the game. Martin, with right, and Rice, and the foul call.
Well, you've got to say that the emphasis for Bologna of going to this low post, whoever's feeling it, making Tyrese play defense on this occasion, but watch this.
Oh. And you know who provided that pass? Cesis, once again.
But then they see the matchup, the slower big man comes in, they throw it straight to him, use the athleticism, and really make a statement with the play. But I love the way that Bologna are running stuff to the through the low post. I love the way they're looking at the matchup. Rice, make him play some defense. Make him work at both ends.
In the lane too early, so another attempt. Martin.
Well, he only made two in the whole game at the weekend in the Italian league. He's already equaled that, and that's a confidence. That tells you how confident he is. No thought, pulled up, knocked it down.
Now Rice, and he knocks in a three. Both teams really come to life here. Early in the contest. 6.5 minutes to go here in this first quarter. And by this time, fouled by Alexander. Good job by Mbai attacking the basket.
Well, we talked before the game about the fact we thought Bamberg would be the team that would be the aggressor. Bologna have been throwing it inside, penetration early. Really, Djordjevic is obviously making that statement, making that a real emphasis, looking for the advantage, getting very, very deep against the defense. Fire was good then. Didn't have to do it quickly, just did it under control. He's got to go through Heckman and finish the play. He's almost turning away.
Yeah, kind of bailed out on the call. Here's Chalmers coming in for Taylor. Taylor tonight, post-game play while always being a starter.
Impressive thing for me about Bologna's start, Jeff, is they have controlled tempo. They've got back. They've forced Bamberg to get into the half court and have to make big half court plays. And that's what we talked about before. They've got to try and control tempo. Older, he's almost trying to make other people better on the floor.
it up and in. And of course, it's easy. It makes it easier for Zisis just to be able to hand the ball off to a player.
He's like when he lets go of the basketball, it's gonna catch him. That's the replay of the two. But it was just an unintentional. Just caught him after the play had already been caught. I don't think it's a bad one. I think it's more painful than a bad one. You're gonna see it now as he's gonna swing that arm right in across the eye like this. The game, the bigger the moment, the bigger he comes, and he's done that throughout his career on whatever team he's been on, at whatever level, he's managed to be that player who comes up big in big games.
He'll be the first person to tell you it doesn't matter how many points he scores, he will score.
Yep.
He's got 7 tonight. He missed the first couple of shots, but since then he's starting to take off. Chalmers, oh boy, good defense, but the pass to Kravich. Going back down, put it up in his way. Oh, going to come in and get some minutes. Hickman, a little long. Rebound by Chalmers.
They've definitely made a commitment as a team to the glass, Bologna. That's a game where they box really well, and then everyone goes after it.
Hunter. And he's brought his A-game tonight so far, folks. Kevin Punter.
He got away with one on the first part of the play, but after that, you could argue he had his hand on his back, but there really wasn't a lot of pushing and contact.
So Punter's going to take a seat, and Loyola comes in for him. So perhaps what they lose in scoring from Punter, they gain in defense.
Yep.
Loyola. And also ball handling.
Where Bologna's half-court sets without Punter, really, they have to work for each other. They great pick and roll execution. Kravich has got to hold down and finish the play. Couldn't have executed it much better.
Taylor. Ball knocked out of bounds.
see the one thing that I'm a little surprised at that Rubit hasn't got touches at the ball. They went to him for the first once or twice down, and they got picked up a couple of fouls. He's not been a factor in the offensive end in terms of getting touches. The referees have changed this, so we're still down this end.
Bamberg possession, 14 on the shot clock. There goes to Harris. Nice up Kravic. Short little jump hook with the left hand. Out of Dory. Loyola. Oh, DeRozan can shoot it from deep, but he gets it to Kravic. Very impactful here. Goes up and scores, and he's got a chance for a three-point play. We talk about an X factor coming off the bench. Kravic has been making the most of his minutes. Still in the first quarter, and he's got 7 points.
That's a tough move as well. I mean, they got a ball reversal, which gave him a little advantage, but he still had a lot to do. Great extension on the follow through. And he's perfect from the floor. And he's playing at his pace. He's not letting the athleticism take him out of the move he wants to make. And he still knocks him down without...
Well, you talked about if he makes it. He came in shooting 67%.
Doesn't. He must have been worse. That's not the way he'd have been taught. He's found a method that works for him. A 10-point lead. This is not the script, is it? Bologna coming out, and they're the team that's actually moving the ball and getting early points.
Hickman into Harris. Going up, gets it back to Hickman. Oh, Hickman missed the layup.
Him that way, and then you reach back the other way. And for a player of Hickman's experience and years of playing the game, that's what big games do to you. In this situation, they're a little tense. They're down 10. They're actually looking to make things happen. Their defensive rules do not say in the low post you're going to reach and try it.
Paul DeRozan at the line misses his first one. Shot at 83%. I like to move it.
super defense, though. They kept it down one side. They forced the cut out of the direct line to the ball. And then they're putting the ball down in traffic. The Bologna defense at the minute is the decisive factor.
And he goes to Kravitz, and he gets rejected by Rubin. Now Hickman. Bumped by Corno. And maybe that'll be a play that'll spark this Bamberg team into life.
That's a great, you see the play here with a block. That's exactly what they want. They want the spark, they want to run, and Kudo comes up with a great foul. I mean, he does not want this game to get open and any momentum. Sensible foul, smart foul, and nothing changes in the game.
Hickman takes it down deep and then turns it over into the hands of Paiola, who immediately pushes it up the floor. Corno, all right. A foul call, Rubens. Pressure on that defense.
Execution and the defensive effort, the rotation got them the steal, but they came down the floor. Their spacing was great. Corner had the chance to penetrate and didn't think. It's just a commitment to each other here on the field system. The way they're running their break, the defensive rotations are tremendous. And if we're all on the same page and make decisions from that point, don't turn the ball over very often. You're in a great position. You're getting shots you want, shots you prepared to take. But you have to make the throws.
Well, he was a 50% shooter from the line this season. Ball knocked out of bounds. So, 12-point deficit here in this Bamberg team, which, again, Precisa's back in the game. And you wonder about the tempo. This game played how they want it to be. Here's Taylor for three. Still doesn't go down. That's a good looking shot, but just didn't fall. Baldarossi gets it. Down to Kravitz. It's that streak of fakes. Harris. The oldest been active, hasn't he?
He's been a real. You said it on the cutting commentary, Jeff. Defensively, he's long. He's long and quick. He's a handful for anybody.
Jesus gets it down low. Quickly, Corno. Out of Dori. Spins. Gets the end. Gets rejected by Harris.
Replay of Aridori's penetration. Poor decision, poor shot. You know, he had it the block, but if you get Thesis with the shot he had before, happened to pray off the dribble, late shot, your defense has been successful, whether he makes it or misses it. Aridori, for the first time, makes a bad decision for them in transition. So long you're just controlling this with their defense at the moment.
Oh, good D by Taylor, comes out, knocks it away, now takes it, White and Aridori, and it gets blocked by Kravitz. But the ball was already off the glass, and that is goal interference.
And that's, you know, look, Taylor on the penetration protects it well. Obviously, it's a goaltend, but someone's in the passing lane. Someone's trying to make something happen to their defensive end, but that's where it has to change if they're going to create the change. Bologna have taken a timeout.
That was a close call, wasn't it? Looking at that.
I was happy to stick with the first look, just that the first look, obviously, look, but in defense has to be like it was the last possession in the pass.
Alexander out there. Sorry, Kravitz. Now Taylor turns, gets blocked behind by Alindi. So it's starting to see some plays on defense now by Bamberg. Hickman.
Says that. That's what he does. Doesn't put it on the floor very well, but shoots the jump shot. You've got to make it put it on the floor.
Hickman puts it up from deep. misses everything. He was hoping to get a call.
By punch, if you're not going to take it expecting to make it or with confidence and prepared to take the hit, don't take it. You know, you've got your 12 point lead, draw the contact or recycle.
Ravage is going to come out and Morea is going to come back into the game. Morea already with some fouls. Taylor and up ahead it goes to Adedori. Nobody back. Parego and Bamberg need another timeout, facing now their biggest deficit of the game, 29-15.
Well, Adedori leaks out, but Taylor took the three. No one goes safe. He looks at the shot, doesn't recover himself. Probably that one play sums up where Bamberg are. They are a step off this. And we questioned the Hickman jump shot earlier on, and I agree with you 100%, you questioned it. But that's almost how they play. But you can't play that. Because then again, they haven't played the team with the scoring power that Bamberg have, so there's always a good time to break a record in the Final Four.
So alarm bells ringing down Bamberg for sure. They know they're definitely in a hole here against Virtus. Jesus. Alexander, that was the message. Get it inside the big cliff, but he can't get it to go.
Baseline was wide open for him. He just went the wrong way. Good execution. 2 feet from the bucket. Couldn't finish the play.
Taylor drives in. No basket. Foul before the shot. You know, just Vitor Edith, the coach of Iberia Tenerife, made the point yesterday, you know, he won it as the coach of Tenerife, so what do you have to do to win one of these things? He said, more than anything, you need a little bit of luck. You know, sometimes the shots fall, and sometimes they don't. And Bamberg, they missed some shots, but some of them have been pretty easy to come in. That last one, an example. Here's Mbai. Over to Morea. Morea gets it back. Now Mbai, the France International, drives in. Denied by Alexander. Closing frame, really, is going to be a real advantage for this Bamberg team. They haven't really been able to take full advantage. Rice for three! And look out, Tyrese Rice is back in the game.
Transition basket off of a defensive play. Defensive set. Rice is the scorer.
Bacon, put it up another three. I tell you what, is he special or what? knowing his team needs him.
It's interesting how Bologna are going to decide to guard him. You know, there's an argument to say, you know, go under. And it's, Rice has matured over the years. He has so many ways to score on you.
This by Taylor. Jesus, unsportsmanlike. It's been called on Adedoni. And boy, this is a real opportunity for Bamford. And Parego relieved the call was made. Look at this. Okay, so this is Rice hitting that last three. And here's Jesus. He wasn't playing the ball.
Aradori can have no complaint. That's the way the call's been made in recent times.
So potential, if all things go well here, the free throws, and a potential three, it could be a 5-point trip down the floor.
Makes it an 8-0 run in a matter of moments with a three before Marais, so. Stepped on it straight away, no easy pass, and they get rewarded the defense again.
Jesus. And again, ball just not going down for Bamford. Martin. Back to Hunter. Hunter goes up the line.
Loose, he comes up with it, then makes a great play.
To be a champion, now playing in Europe. Just when you think Bamber might be about to make a move, they're just going to come back. They lost 4 unanswered points. Just 5, he makes a free throw.
It's not going your way, is it? And that's all you can do. You know your team has got the ability to come through this.
Hey, Baldirossi with the offensive rebound and put back. Back to a 14-point game. Hickman left open, puts up a long three. Chalmers brings it back. He's going to pull up and he's going to miss. But the ball bounces out to Envy, and still Bamberg just can't quite get hold of the ball.
Well, Bamberg, a team that averages plus 81 points a game at 25 coming up to the half. With no second chance points. The game's been too controlled. The longer have set the tempo, set the tone. They're going to have to bring a lot more defensively in the second half.
Hunter, another three. Well, all balance or not, he's going to put it up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He's got the green light.
Yep.
17 points. And Bamberg fans looking on in misery right now. Here's this. Another A game. Hickman finds his way, gets it over to Heckman. Shot clock about to expire, puts it up, and Rubin's the offensive rebound! Oh, what a way to finish at the end of the shot clock. And the referee saying he definitely got that off in time. Watch this. The foot.
That's a foul. That's a foul. And Borrego's quite right. You know, he's controlled his bench really well, but still made the point without it becoming an issue. But Kevin Punter, what a first half coming off the back of probably the worst run in his career offensively. But what did we say? Final fours are final fours. What you've been doing before doesn't mean a thing. Coming to the game with that confidence at that level, he's looking for back-to-backs.
Well, absolutely. Bamberg has got the deficit back to four. Rice. Burning Chalmers knocks it away. He steals it. He puts up a three. Well, that would have been a way to finish the first half. Nevertheless, you have to say, Virtus, they'll settle for the 14-point advantage. Georgevich, perhaps not excited.
First 5 minutes, so important, they say, the start of the second half, especially for the team that is down.
They're going to get back into it. They need to start getting back into it now. Second half underway. And it's 14 points the advantage for Virtus. Hunter with his 12 first half points. Leads his team over to Mbai. And he starts with a three.
There was no defender within 8 feet of him when he let that go. They just got to step up and play some defense.
17 points, the advantage. Elias Harris puts it up at the line, misses, nobody there for the rebound.
Second guess himself, Kudakish put it, shot it. They offered it in. Just got to shoot that with confidence if you're going to let it go.
One right spot, Mark, and the steal by Rice. Goes down and is fouled by Taylor. Here's the look at the steal from Rice. Taylor will step in front. Watch this. Remember, the most wins in the Basketball Champions League this season while trailing at halftime. They've got five. So, but this is a big mountain to climb. 17 points.
Well, we know they're going to get some scores here. They're going to get a momentum shot at some point.
Johan Russo calling the foul, the push off with the left forearm on Zisis. I honestly thought it was a bit of a delayed call, but I think he got the right call.
Yeah, I think so.
Three fouls now on Zisis. Well, we know Virtus aren't going to be going to the Italian playoffs, but what a strong performance and a title would mean for them if they could get it here this weekend. And by hands it off, man, the dunk. But the shot.
shot clock expired. But this game right now is just being dominated. Look at this.
You saw the problem. I mean, okay, the shot clock's expired, but Rice just let him go down the middle. Didn't, like, rotate, didn't get into the lane. At some point, they've got to decide to play defense.
Nice.
Great shot. You got the help coming. No one really helped anybody.
And even Rubin with, or Harris with the follow, missed the dunk, the putback dunk. Morea. Going up against Rubin. Now Taylor. Hunter for three. Oh, money! Kevin Hunter is back with a vengeance.
Wow. They rule over him when he knocked that one down.
And there's a look of a satisfied look on the sidelines for Coach Georgievich, thinking we're not going to lose if Kevin Punter is pouring into points like he is right now. Taylor bounce pass kicked away.
And it's the longer the team that are chasing over screens, that are getting into lanes, that are breaking up plays. They're the team with a 20-point lead because they're doing that, as well as the fact that punts are just boring in points.
Now you're right. It starts on the defensive end. Here's Rice. Steps back. Misses, and Punter with another rebound. And it seems to be going from bad to worse for Bamberg. Three-pointer from Punter this time. Rice with the rebound. Now Zisis quickly gets blocked by Morea. Good rim protection by the Angola International. Rubit short.
Three white shirts, one dark shirt going off of that. It just sums up where Bamberg are.
Harris almost getting the steal. They end up getting it to Taylor, who hands it off to Rice. Drives in, and the foul called. A block. And Rice making sure he's going to get some contact.
Clearly a foul. There's lots of people like standing up saying, oh, you know, he did a charge or whatever. He's moving across. His arms outside him. It's a foul any way you look at it.
Here's Taylor at the other end, and right before the turnover. I mean, there's no need for, if you're here, to let anything take you out of your game right now. You're up 20 points. You don't get a call you like, you just let it go.
What it tells you is they are so into this at the moment. They've got that momentum. They're playing every single possession relentlessly. And they've just got, and I think they will, but Georgievich is going to make sure they do. They've just got to be stayed with what's working. That control in what you run. Get this guy the ball.
Well, the pass to Morea. Gets it down, has it knocked away by Taylor. Good job by Taylor again defensively. Now Rice gets blocked by Martin. Boy, neither team giving away much down low now. Look at Martin go up and deny arguably the player of the year in the competition.
There's just an ocean of difference between the level of the intensity of these, both these teams at the minute. Bologna just are relentless in the way they're executing what Georgievich has asked.
Hit by from the right corner. Good job by Taylor down low. Pushing Morea out. Zisis getting the rebound. Taylor for three, and a foul called on Mbai. A little bit of elbow action on the box out. Right now, Jesus fouled Taylor. Taylor's got foul trouble. Four fouls on Tony Taylor.
And that's exactly what we were talking about. He got the, since he had that steal and he lost possession, he committed two bad ones. Like two ones where he's just trying to make things happen. He doesn't have, he's working hard enough, things will happen. And he's gonna have to sit, and he's, they're gonna lose him from the game.
To be fair though, I mean, they, not, yeah, definitely hasn't been his best game, but Mariners have been tough.
Overall, you take his intensity because it's reflected the rest of the group.
Yeah, absolutely. Buzzer, Martin Rice. Rice lost it. It went to Harris. Rice got it back, and he was surrounded. Shot clock violation. Just nothing there for Bamberg.
Like Hunter, before this happened, in the passing lane, making Rice take a second cut to receive the pass, making him work hard to catch it. Chasing him through the screen, Rice is out of control. Everyone's scrambling for it, violation. They've turned them over again. And it's just defensive effort and commitment to what they're doing. It's just phenomenal by the line.
Adedori, captain, turns, puts it up. Little turnaround, jumper, no good. Rubin with the board. But we're past the midway point now in the third quarter, and it's still an 18-point lead for Virtus. Harris turns quickly, goes in, and gets the foul called on Mbai. Those two are really going at it. Kravitch also comes back into the game, and Morea takes a seat, so pretty good minutes for Morea, and now Kravitz, who really helped set the tone in the first half, is back in the game. At least a little bit of intensity now from Harris. Maybe that'll transfer to his teammates. Makes both.
They've got a chunk of the game now. This is like halfway through the third. With the next 4 minutes, get into a manageable number. With the 5 minutes in the first part of the fourth, and then they're right in contention. They can't look at the 16-point margin, just at possession by possession.
Pass to Kravitz. He's going to Harris, loses it. Ball falls right back to him. Now Chalmers. And I think that was after the shot clock. No, they let him play. Now Zisas. Bamberg. And a foul called on Chalmers. Harris is doing a great job now for Bamberg.
Well, we were saying they were looking for someone. If it's Harris, it doesn't matter who it is, someone's got to spark. Really, really got to get stops.
They were dodging a bullet there. That was Adedori with an easy putback. And Harris misses the first. Harris, an 82% free throw shooter on the season coming into this game in the Basketball Champions League. Something, Virtus have an answer. What a finish. And Harris just a little slow getting into position there. Picks up the foul. David Corno comes in for Punter.
With this punter's timeout in the game, this is where Bonkerosha got, absolutely have to defensively step it up, make someone else make a play, build that momentum.
Now Rice has to fight, he finally gets the ball, tries to get it back, it's knocked away, the quick hands of Virtus, defensively they're everywhere.
A super recognition. Again, transition, they space. Bruce is at the front of the ring, guarded by Tyrese Rice, who's had to get back and be safe. And you've still got to recognize it, you've still got to get it there. They didn't panic, they changed the passing angle. Easy entry pass, only ever going to be a foul in the situation. Rice has to use the foul.
You know, Borrego was looking at the refs and saying that Kravitz had both of his hands wrapped around the man behind him. And it was clear right there on the highlight. Here's Adedori. Chalmers on the baseline. Rubin gets it over to Rice. Harris again goes hard to the basket, but this time Aldirosa knocks it away. Good defense by Harris that time. Adedori with a little runner. It's good. And they simply just do not have many answers. Defensively, however, Virtus making plays themselves.
Well, you saw the replay, Jeff, on that again. They move the ball in transition. The defense hasn't shifted. He's got a huge hole to penetrate in. And he's a quality player. He's guys who can just flat out score. But they've absolutely have to get stops.
Well, it was a 14-point deficit at halftime. And as you said, it has grown to 20 points. Here's Hickman trying again. Finishes.
I always like to see them press a little, push up the floor, try and create with their defense.
Adedori for three. Well, that helps. Bamberg.
But they're not running out of the miss. You know, no one committed to the break, and they're having to take a tough runner.
Well, Alexander there for the putback, and he was fouled. He knows he should have probably made that. It nevertheless goes to the line.
Major issue yet for Bologna, but the fouls are starting to build up on the bigs. And again, you'd expect then Bamberg to be more aggressive, force them to actually play defense. That's Baldassarre's third. So they're beginning to have a beginning, but they're not going to exploit it unless they commit them and unless they are aggressive going to the glass.
Well, Alexander misses that, able to get the rebound. The ball is tapped to him, I think, by Alindi. Hickman at the line, tough shot. Good rebound, Alexander keeps it alive. Continue to stay with it, but then Chalmers takes it away and he just goes all the way, gets rejected, but there for the follow and Kravitz couldn't quite tap it in. Well, that's a lot of action with no scoring on both ends. Rice quickly goes in, tries to get some contact and a trip to the line, but now Adedori. The deficit, 108 to go. I don't know about you, but I think the refs are doing a good job today.
I would say to you that they have done this. They've been very, very consistent. I don't think it's a foul. There's a lot of people a little animated about the Adedori penetration, but he didn't go strong. He gave the defense a chance to contest it.
And that was just good defense by Chalmers, but great hustle by Alindi, and then Kravitz just missed an easy putback.
Another example, again, though, like, most of the game, Bamberg chasing the game, get out worked. It's a testimony to the relentless way that Bologna are playing the game, but Kravitz is not the quickest guy on the floor. He just committed to getting down the floor better than anybody else.
Back into the game. bench. And Hunter is also back in. Shot here. Chalmers hands it off to Morea. Takes it back outside. Now over to Porno. And Alexander with the rebound. That door opening ever so slightly here for Bamberg to get back into it. Rice for three. And that was short and Hunter there. No. Shirts under for the rebound. So it's a Lindy guarding Hunter. And now they switch on to Alexander. And Hunter puts it up, misses everything. And just a little bit of time for Rice. And couldn't quite get a hold of it. So at the end of three quarters, Segafredo, Virtus Bologna, 53. Borussia Bamberg, 39, have had five of their shots blocked in the basketball Champions League game. And we're still now just at the start of the fourth quarter, so we got 10 minutes remaining. Here's Rice, gets in. Boy, he should have made that one, he thinks.
This is definitely a manageable margin. They're not going to shoot 24% for a game. Hard to knock a lot of shots down in this fourth quarter.
Switch on Hunter. Hempman got his hand up and Lindsay with the rebound. Hickman drives in, gets it up to Alexander, hoping to get an alley-oop. Gets it back. Hickman passes up the three, drives in, and great defense. Knocking it off the rim, I think, was Morea.
That's a great play by Hector. He gets right to the ring under pressure. All he has to do is finish the layup. And you know, it is one of those nights. For them at the moment, it's one of those nights.
And now a foul called on Alexander. Guarding him and was beaten, didn't give up.
Oh, that's the thing. Absolutely, that's the thing. That sums up his Bologna performance.
39 points, the lowest point total for a Bamberg team in the Basketball Champions League this season after three quarters. Martin catches it. 5 seconds left. Here to still have another chance. Frustration for the Bamberg fans. But where there's hope, there's life. And still 8:39 to go. Now 2.5 seconds. Are they going to throw near the rim? No, they get it to Punter. They'll settle for that.
Kevin Punter, the all-time leading scorer in basketball Champions League history, has just hit another three-pointer. And that was with time running out. That might have just been a dagger. Here's Hickman. Ball goes in and out. Alexander not able to hold on to the rebound. Bottom line is you got to put the ball in the basket, and the way Punter has come out today with 18 points, he has been utterly sensational.
There's your question. It was a great play, but who else was going to shoot it? And they allow him to catch the basketball. No one switched into the lane. Defensively, they just have been so, you know, we keep saying it, they've just got basically to the team.
Well, Morea misses on the baseline. And again, Hickman maybe got away with a little bit of a push. And he just can't get it to go down. It's oh so close. But that one rattled out.
That's back-to-back rattlers, isn't it? Yeah, the other one was wide open, rattled out. And there's almost a resignation for Bamberg at the moment. It's just not happening. Oh!
And the foul, the follow-up. Not sure if they're going to count that, the foul call before the
shot.
Yeah,
I think so. There's the foul, yeah. But again, it's Bologna outworking every spot, 1-5. Just relentlessly. It's an amazing defensive performance to give a team the 39 points with that much talent on the floor.
First one is good by Tony Taylor. It's been pretty quiet offensively. 4 points for him. And there for the follow, Morea. Boy, he's been sensational. Great hustle by Morea. In the big, we thought about this Virtus team maybe at a disadvantage on the interior, but their bigs have been outstanding.
Unbelievably. Unbelievable performance by every single guy on the inside.
Great.
Bamberg still takes shots like that. That's all they're getting. They're not getting anything open. They're not getting anything off what they're on. They're relying on individual plays. And down this end,
just now white. Now Punter's just unstoppable. He scores on another drive to the basket. And he says, don't forget, folks, I can do whatever I want. He saw the ball go in the basket early in the game, and that was like a shot across the bow. Sure enough, he has erupted for 20 points. Getting ready to add to his tally. And really, you go back to that 2.5 seconds left on the shot clock. They inbounded the ball. They got it to him. He was a full meter behind the arc. Put it up and scored. And really, that was almost game over at that point. That's how you felt. Now the lead is 63-39. So 21 points, the game high for Kevin Punter. I suppose really this Virtus team, we always knew they had the capacity to win this competition from the very beginning of the season. They hit a funk. They've obviously had problems. They're not going to the Italian playoffs. But here they are looking formidable. And quick shot put back by Harris. Also, as Punter has it, you know, what was George been saying yesterday? We need to come here with joy in our faces. We need to be happy, play with joy. I mean, it looks like they played with a lot of anger today, to be honest. They've taken it out on Bamberg.
They played with so much intensity. 100% committed to whatever Coach George has asked them to do because their organization, their structure has been sensational.
Mbai steps into a three. Rubin rebounds it. Well, if it's going to be a comeback, it'll be the greatest in basketball Champions League history. Certainly with the magnitude of this game. Here's Harris getting in, nowhere to go. It's just the quick hands of Virtus giving away nothing. They're blocked by Rubin. Rice for three. Good. 19 points, the deficit.
Martin's on the floor. You know, on. While he's on the floor, there's always hope. It's this end of the floor.
Correa. And then a foul called. Here's Rice in transition.
Like that actually got the miss. If Coach Borrego dreamt the worst way the game could go, this is it. Allowing Bologna to set the tone, allowing Bologna to dictate the pace of the game. But more importantly, their defense just has not given them any momentum at all.
Foul was called on Rubin. And Correa makes one of two. Just take it back to a 20-point lead with 4:50 to go. Denver fans praying for a miracle comeback. Cesis puts up a three. Ekman now to Rice. It goes up strong and gets a foul as well. Where has that been all game?
Just what I was going to ask. That's just ripped. He rips it through. Watch. Step through. And the problem we thought that they were going to have defensively containing him, that's why we thought it. Nothing fancy. Just a straightforward rip through. Got the advantage and finished the play. He's on the line. 4:31 is a long time if you start getting stops and making some big shots.
Clock stops.
Yep.
Well,
but you have to score from the line.
Rubin doesn't take advantage. 82% shooter, 83% shooter from the free throw line during the season. So 18 points to lead. Tony Taylor. Ball rims out. Called on Cesis, getting tied up for the rebound.
They allow Bologna to run it down to 3 seconds on the possession.
Yeah.
And that's, it's almost like they don't have an answer. Because they just literally just played half-court defense. They ran it down to 20 seconds, got a shot, and then didn't box out.
By misses a free throw. Tell you, I would have said he was the revelation of the season in the Basketball Champions League, the way he played. He, you know, was invited into France's national team for the World Cup qualifiers.
It's always interesting to me how players flourish in different environments. And he's obviously enjoying life there. Bologna used to be one of those hot spots of European basketball. This is one of those steps they take to get back to that level.
So not over the limit yet. Just three team fouls on Virtus. Harris drives in, puts it up, misses the layup. Rubin, rebound.
Travel.
Ball for the travel. And that is...
Well, if you're looking for a play to sum it up, Harris missing a wide open layup with no one there.
I mean, you would think he would dunk that.
Yeah. Well, the way Bamberg play, that's definitely a dunk. That's what they do.
Travis quickly to Taylor. Gets it over to Adedori. Ball up quickly here. Rubin, little jump hook,
just will not go down. Rims were tight. Whenever Bamberg put it up,
it's like someone's put a lid on it for him.
Punter again. And Harris this time does make the layup. Well, you know, Virtus, they've won 15 Italian championships, 8 Italian Cups, a couple of EuroLeague titles, the Porter Cup, Euro Challenge. But the last one was that Euro Challenge 10 years ago. And now, as we get closer to the end of this game, it looks like they're going to be playing for another major title. Taylor drifts in, loses it. And an extra effort from Kravic almost gets him another basket. Zisas puts it up from deep. Tyrese Rice has done his part tonight. 5 3-pointers. That's the most any player has ever hit in a Final Four game.
Harris has 9 points now. But as we saw earlier, he's missing a couple of mates. They just had no transition baskets. They're not really. They've just been one of those days. You have those days, they just happen to have had it in the semifinal of the Basketball Champions League. But you can't. It does come from your defense. Everything comes from your defense. And they just not put a defensive performance on the floor at all.
Goodbye. That does it. You have to say, there's no way back for Brosa Bamberg, trailing by 17 points. Once Virtus went up by 12 points, you knew it was going to be a huge ask because they hadn't lost any game after leading by as many as 12. And Punter, who's just been sensational today, gets the rebound and brings it up. So Virtus Bologna, one of the most famous clubs in European basketball, now one step, one win away from another title. Who will they play? Will they play host Telenet Giants Antwerp? Or will they play Iberostar Tenerife? That'll be the second semifinal tonight. Chalmers, now Heckman. And this is gonna be a tough pill to swallow for Bamberg as they go back home. Of course, they're going to play in the third place game. They'll play the loser of the next semifinal. But for Virtus, they were prepared, they were focused, and really Georgievich transmitted the game plan. He said, guys, defensively, we need to lock down. We need to be active. And he really did a good job with his timeouts.
Everything.
Virtus Bologna, Segafredo Virtus Bologna winning 67-50 over Brosa Bamberg to advance to the final of the basketball championship.